Hey y'all, my name's Tyson, and this time around, let's just do some a basic practice exercise together. So recently, I've done some videos that were showing inference laser tools, and what that does, one of the things it does is create finger joints or box joints. And that led me to thinking this is just a good exercise being able to resolve that sort of thing. And that's what we're going to do. So follow along and let's practice some basic SketchUp techniques. To start, we're going to draw a box. The size doesn't really matter. If you want to be precise, let's say 24 by 30, but that's not going to matter. One thing that will matter is make it a known height. So I'm going to say 1 inch. And then I select this, group it, and then we could do a number of different ways, but I'm just going to draw in the blue direction a couple more segments. Now I could select any one of these or the corner segments. And also make a copy. But I want this to just be variable, right? No even spacing. So when we have that, I'm going to come in here and I'm going to push that back 1 inch, right? We raised our panel, or at least I did 1 inch. So whatever distance you used, do the same thing. And I'm going to add one more segment here. And that way, when I'm done, I'll have same on either side. So there, that's our starting point. And let's make a copy of this. So we're gonna copy this up, and then we could use the move tool, rotate grips, or the rotate tool. Either way, rotate a version vertical and then move it back into place. And what we want to do is change all of this panel so that it will match and we have the finger joints in here. Now, again, this is variable spacing and that's on purpose. But the way that you can make this challenging for yourself is to do a couple things. Let me make one copy of this so we can do that. For example, in this version, I'm going to pick a view. Let's just say this view right here. And I'm going to resolve all of this without ever moving my camera. Now, I am definitely an advocate that you should be orbiting often. But if I move this back into place, I'm going to challenge myself to say, can I move these pieces without moving my camera? I should be able to. And here's some of the way in which we do it. I can, for example, use push-pull, pull to this edge, and then using a selection window. And I can't really see, but if I turn X-ray mode on, I can see that I've selected that. But this is also part of the exercise, is to kind of imagine yourself being able to select a face using a left to right selection back here without even turning X-ray mode on. And also, say for over here, we'd know that we'd get in trouble because back here we have overlapping. So we'll have to do a little bit more work. But the point is, I'm going to turn X-ray mode on and start moving this. Now, maybe I will invoke the red inference and this, I wasn't careful enough. You can see my geometry is stretching. So I'm going to select this again. Check my selection, move this into place. I could use push pull or move tool. So I've got all these pieces done. This one, like I said, maybe from here, if I select all of this geometry, if I look, I've got a little too much back here. And again, my challenge is to stay in the same view. So what I might do is grab all of this. I don't want that edge, so remove that edge and move this over. And then from there, I can grab this piece, move it back. Or I might need to create new geometry in here. But again, this is not the best way that we would do this. We would orbit around, as we'll see. But the point of this, hopefully, is just challenge yourself to do something a little bit like, okay, this is not the most efficient way, but could I still complete this exercise? And I think to do this, oh, I've zoomed in and out. All right. So I think we've got it. I use this last one and we're done. Again, the whole point of that is to say, can you stay in one view and challenge yourself to use inference locking, to use X-ray mode, to use selection methods, and to be able to resolve that geometry just from one view, just because it's a challenge, just because it might introduce some things for you that you haven't previously thought to do. Or don't restrict yourself to one view and just say, how fast can I do this? Well, now that we just did this last one, we might be able to use, and I'll inference lock to here, then push pull, and then grab this section, move, lock the red direction, push pull, pull. So challenge yourself, how quickly can I resolve these? And lock to here, inference lock, reference that face, inference lock, draw past, and done. But doing little simple exercises like this, I find just to be really useful for improving your speed at inference locking, your speed at making selections, or even just making decisions on what's going to be a more efficient method of selecting a face with the move tool, moving and locking it, or using push-pull, turning X-ray on so that you can see through and make a good selection. There we go. It is a very simple example, like I said, but I do think it's one that if you just for practice inference locking, practice turning your X-ray mode on and off, you can see that just it's really helpful to be able to just switch between locking, manipulating geometry with the move tool versus push-pull, turning X-ray mode on and off. We didn't explore the ability that you can turn your components and other parts of the model on and off based on your editing, but that too. So simple exercise, but one that I think is worth this and other things, just practicing simple things just to improve your efficiency and make your speed in SketchUp better. I don't know. What do you think? is this a waste of time, or do you think, you know what, try it. Try it a couple times. Maybe you get better at inferencing. Who knows? Let us know what you think. And as always, let us know if you have questions or suggestions for other topics that we can cover. We'd love to have that conversation. We'd love to take those suggestions and make them real. So thanks as always. Please do like and subscribe. See y'all next time.